nursing their wrath ever since. It was the long-awaited chance to even the score, and more importantly, to begin to haul back Rangers' commanding lead over their oldest rivals. Archie McPherson is the commentator.
Roy Aiken and Terry Butcher lead Rangers and Celtic out onto a tumultuous reception. It is raining in Glasgow, which is hardly a unique phenomenon, but in fact, traditionally, when we have weather like this, we usually get very fine games indeed. The pitch is holding, and I think both sets of players will enjoy it. The Celtic side, while they can field the 11 men who played in Bremen on Tuesday night, I thought they were extremely good, particularly their defence, and one of the stars was Mick McCarthy. There was a certain doubt about the Republic of Ireland internationals before this game. He had a muscle injury, but as you can see, he's fit and ready to go. There is Rangers, who are much changed, of course. They had a couple of suspensions and a couple of injuries on Wednesday night when they played against Cologne. But they are back to something like their full strength, missing, and I think vitally missing for them, is Ali McCoist, who has a serious hamstring injury. But back in the side, that creative midfield player, Ray Wilkins, the English internationalist. And there's the referee for today, George Smith from Edinburgh. Well, Rangers at the moment are 7 points clear of Celtic, so it is vital for Celtic to draw them back. Rangers are leading Aberdeen by 4 points in the league, and Celtic and their supporters are desperate for a win today to keep them in touch, to retain the championship title. The rain is driving down. I'm not quite sure, I can't quite make up my mind as the game starts in which direction it's blowing. It's sort of diagonally left to right. It's certainly not the traditional west wind that we get here. That is offside. Linesman right in line with the play. Kevin Drinkle, slight touch of the head. You'll see Mark Walters, I think, going through the middle for Rangers to start off with. Drinkle, that'll be a free kick, I think. McCarthy pushing from the back. McCarthy's great strength is in the air, no doubt about it. Loves getting up and above them all. I think it was vital for Celtic that he was fit to play this afternoon. Bit of instruction there by Roy Aiken. There's John Brown with the touch and a very good clearance by Bonner. Now Cooper. Walters brought that down superbly. Look at that. Free kick and a magnificent piece of play by Walters. Rogan brought him down. Look at this, he brought that ball, and that's a typical little double shuffle of his. But the way he pulled the ball and brought it to his feet, the very best of skill. Ferguson is in! Up goes Ferguson, and Richard Goff watches it very carefully. Roy Aiken. There's Goff, all very untidy at the moment. Bounds. And offside. McCarthy will take this. Ferguson, nobody behind him. Look like a hand, and it's to Billy Starr. Exit Marin, ex Aberdeen. That's a very good ball. And just passed by McAvenny. A great effort by Celtic's prolific goal scorer, who's having, I think, one of the best seasons he's ever had. Now look at the way he gets in very sharply there, getting in before the defender. McCarthy well up for it again. Ferguson to Brown. Slight hesitation and away goes Walters though. There are a lot of experienced players on the field, but believe you me, this is a test of nerve for everybody. Again like this, that's offside. I think the rain has eased up, which is a blessing. But there are 60,000 now crammed into the stadium. That's down to Walters. That looks like a penalty. Well, the referee waves play on. Now, certainly seen penalties given for that. This was the tackle. All the way back to Stevens. Out come the defenders. That's strong and offside. That's Anton Rogan, internationalist from Northern Ireland, and up and over by Richard Goff. This will be the first real test of this Celtic set position. See what they can do with it. It's a far post, and just away. Richard Goff was in there. That was a very good ball indeed. All the Rangers defenders had to turn, and even though Cooper missed it, he had Richard Goff right behind him. There he is. Paul McStay must let fly it. This will throw. Brilliantly saved. A magnificent save there by Chris Woods. That's a great piece of football by McStay. He saw the opportunity, he had to go way to the outside, and look at that. Rangers under pressure. And Celtic are doing a lot of the near post ball, and that is causing problems to Rangers. Drinkle is up, and that's another corner. Look at that congested goal line. Mick McCarthy, Terry Butcher beside him. You're trying to go to that near post again. There it is. Butcher at the back, though. Ferguson. And the goal kick. Aiken picking up a lot of balls in midfield now, but that's John Brown. A bit of a punt there, and a very difficult ball to take under wet conditions. Back to his own keeper. I think Mark Walters there raring to go. He's had some delightful touches today. There he is again. Just easing his way down that touchline. It's a long one, and Mick McCarthy in for that. Dominating in the air as he was in Germany on Tuesday, where I thought he was quite superb for Celtic. Organised them well and inspired them. Feels for a penalty it is. A handling offence. A low draw, and Rangers, who had an appeal earlier on, turned down, get the penalty. The referee right on the spot saw a hand used. Now here it was, up it went, and it came, I think, either off the hand of Rogan or McCarthy, but it's a penalty kick. Now normally Davy Cooper or Ali McCoist would take penalties. And certainly a hard one for this man, Mark Walters, at this stage. Here he goes. He's done it. Straight through the goalkeeper. He didn't even bother angling it. Watch this. The goalkeeper undecided, but Walters certainly was not. And that is with 17 minutes gone. Looking for a 1-2 here. And Richard Gough keeps his eye on the ball. Was much too obvious by Drinkle in that defensive position. Away by Butcher. Celtic having Rangers in at the moment. Cooper. That's good play by Rangers. Ferguson breaks. Ferguson. No, he couldn't get an opening. Brown, that's a throw to Celtic. Well, thought it was. And McAvennie has typified the Celtic spirit today. He's not only getting up and trying his chance in the penalty area, he's coming back, fighting very hard for it. Cooper, Drinkle, and turning his man round, that'll be a free kick. It's wide, and it gives Rogan the chance to go to the line. Well, that's the wrong way. And Stevens right off balance. Another free kick, and you can see how well McGee troubles the defence by turning quickly like that. There he is, ex-Aberdonian, ex-Hamburg. And it's all pushing and shoveling in there just now, isn't it? Oh, that's an own goal! Terry Butcher! An own goal by Rangers captain. He was trying to clear that for a corner, and now it's 1-1. Beautifully picked up by Wilkins. No, the pass not good enough. Now here, drifting that in. Nicked down by Stevens. The game, of course, traditionally played at a frantic pace, and this has been no exception. McCarthy. Stevens after this. Stevens, I think, trying to slip this man rather than tackle. Walters. There's McCarthy. Can't find his man. Walter Smith, the assistant manager at Ibrox, lashing his players there. Good old tongue lashing. Richard Goff was up. Drinkle. And there's Cooper. I think he's offside though. Yes, he had crept into an offside position. Just pushed to the side by Drinkle. Watch him just reverse passing this, shaping one there, then the other, and Cooper offside. He was going to miss that anyway. Brown took his eye off that. Seemed to have it well covered. McAvenny. Well away. Stark. Now McStay. McAvenny, a little bit too much, I think. Now Celtic at the corner kick. Trying to keep the pressure on Rangers. Try and find McCarthy again. And Ferguson, none too sure of himself. And here's Tommy Burns. Lofting it in. Mark McGee turning on it. Oh, he's got it through. Mark McGee scoring for Celtic. That makes it 2-1. With the Rangers defence standing stranded. And the pressure has paid off. There it was, Burns in there. Now watch the number of Celtic players on the right then. How he got it through the crowded bodies. And I make it about 9 minutes of this half remaining. Celtic, one behind, now in front. Trying to find Walters. Ferguson. That's a lovely ball, and that just clicked away. Better move by Rangers up front. We've seen very little of them in a concerted manner in the past 15 minutes. It was a very bad corner kick. Rangers are wanting to try and keep the pressure on. Here's Ferguson. That'll be another corner. I'm not sure what Walters is trying. And offside. That's two Rickey's corner kicks taken there. Wilkins hasn't exerted any great influence in this game so far, Wilkins. Just got back there. McAvenny. McAvenny playing very well for Celtic, leading the line well. That was Ian Ferguson. Ian Ferguson in direct competition with Paul McStay. And they both come through the ranks together, these players. Professional youth team and know each other very well. Nicely fed out there by Aiken. McGee over there, and that's a third one. Stark
Billy Stark gets Celtic's third goal. That was delightful play by Celtic. It was a very tight Rangers defence. And then it came to Stark and it was in and off. I think it came off Brown eventually. Celtic supporters really rejoicing. And there goes the half-time whistle. Celtic going off to rapturous applause for fighting back from one goal down. And certainly that opening goal by Rangers, the penalty by Walters, set the mood for the game, with Celtic deciding to fight back. And then that astonishing own goal by Terry Butcher, the goalkeeper having no chance. And McGee, as he always does, fighting hard, getting in there to make it two. And then just before half-time, Billy Stark, and I think an in-off Brown. But anyway, it was three and a very solid lead for Celtic at half-time. And off we go into the second half, but Rangers got a mighty fight on their hands. Andy Gray up front, Neil Cooper off for Rangers. Tommy Bunch shielding that well. Really swirling wind. No, that's a wasted one. Both goalkeepers getting a lot of distance in the air. Certainly take a supreme effort by Rangers to pull this out. Stevens. There's a neat chip forward to Stevens. And he seemed to go away from it. Butcher behind that. Andy Gray advancing on the keeper, prevent the pass back. It's a better play by Rangers. Here's Stevens. There's a through run by Stevens. And just swept away. Good play again by McCarthy. And Rangers' best move of the match, by far. Great combined effort, good understanding by the fullback, and McCarthy doing sterling service. Bonner taking it very well, and angered by the attention. I think you'll get the free kick out of it. Butcher. There's McStay. That's a great move, Aiken. No, poor finish. Nice move, though. Well, he tore that Rangers defence apart again. It's way around the outside, and Walters after this. McCarthy there, though. There's McStay. It's not a bad ball. Butcher covering. Billy Stark to take this. He might be trying the long one again, though. Yes. Can't imagine how Brown thought he would have got away with that. Morris will take this, and the tall men all congregate again in the penalty area. Oh, it was just watch going to the far post. Dominic Stay tries to come up. Well, that's a deflection. That looked netbound. There it was, McStay coming up very quickly. Watch him pouncing on this eventually. And he hit it, and it swerved away. Celtic still in that two-goal lead. Well, I'll tell you, that was fortuitous. Just standing in the right spot. Brown. Just kept that in, but his parting of the ball, very wayward. Woodshaw just gets there. And it's a free kick, saying he leant over his back. There's no use complaining about it. A lot of arguing going on there at Rangers defence. And it goes to McStay. There's the shot! Brilliantly saved! Oh, a magnificent shot, matched by a superb piece of goalkeeping, as you can see, whizzing in. And he must have felt the fingertips very warm after that. Corner kick. Well away by Butcher Buns. Well, Ferguson. Well, it's a bad ball and beyond everybody. Pressure still on them. McGee. Just pulled away, Ferguson. Still not through. Brinkle goes for it, and he's all off balance, and he has no support in any case. That's Butcher with it, and there goes the final whistle. Celtic running out convincing winners by 3-1. Much to the delight of their supporters and the Celtic players themselves, who obviously were seeking revenge after that last game where they were beaten heavily by 5-1. And that means that they keep in